got a severe case of scurvy.
Go, 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 go.
Bye-bye.
We're on a plane.
Oh, Vijay's also there.
He's stolen my window seat.
It's my window seat.
Hotel.
Wow.
Know how close we are to the airport?
That's pretty damn close if you ask me.
It's right there. You can practically smell it.
Nothing's happening today. Nothing to report, nothing. Nothing at all. Nothing. Nothing.
My face is bleeding, and what is happening on TV?
The jar is under the bed.
Then he took a gulp. I took a sip, he took a gulp.
Bro, I'm telling you.
still a bit scary.
A bit too close to home.
Keep going.
I tried.
You tried, now you're halfway gone.
There's a fire over there. A tree is on fire. My phone's gonna die. So from this point on, everything's just gonna be captured with photos. All the important bits. Are you?
Very
nice.
See the enthusiasm.
That's probably fine, right?
It's been 4 years since that footage was filmed. It's taken me 4 years to make this video. Now that could conjure quite a humorous image in the mind that I've been painstakingly editing this video for 4 years straight and now I look like this, which isn't true, but it's been sitting there in my mind for 4 years. Obviously it would be completely insane to try and draw some level of poignant conclusion from a video about a holiday. But I will say that this video is kind of a landmark moment in my movie making career. I was 16 years old.
Here I am in a hot dog costume.
I just finished secondary school.
Hot dog out.
I was making more homemade movies than ever. And this was meant to be this behemoth vlog that documented every single moment of this incredible trip that I would no doubt look back on fondly for years to come. I was planning out all these visual jokes.
You're watching the Ezra News. And they still can't find that poor, poor girl.
I filmed as many fake walking shots as I could. And I was trying to anticipate this final product as I was experiencing the holiday. And midway through, I just realized, oh, this video is boring.
This whole video thing really isn't going as planned. Turns out there's a lot of sightseeing and not a lot of talking. All the talking happens off camera because if I film the talking, it's just a bit weird. Like we just had a fantastic talk about fathers and their absence in our lives.
Shit happened on the holiday that this version of the video doesn't capture. The first thing Rodney did was lose his phone, which put him in a bad mood.
The phone's lost.
If I'm honest, I've got no hope.
That, in turn, by osmosis, put me in a bad mood.
It's midday now, it's 12:30. So, if this could just wrap up.
And then there was just this feedback loop of bad vibes. It wasn't great.
I'm quite angry, if I'm honest. At this point, I'm not even gonna put this in the video.
In general, I found it kind of awkward filming, because inherently, filming things is awkward.
Talking to yourself again.
This camera.
The camera's on.
And stuff just wasn't going to plan, and it all built up to the point where I was like, why am I doing this? I'm the only person filming, editing, and consuming the product, and I'm not having any fun with it. Why don't I just enjoy the holiday?
I just took a sip and he went, no! Even me was like, no, sorry. And they had a big boulder stuff.
So, 4 years. Every so often I did return to the video to try and make it work. I could have committed and made a feature length version of the video with all of the footage as originally intended.
AM on Monday the 7th of August 2017. We're gonna go to America today.
Or I could have injected some clever retrospective commentary to try and breeze through the narrative.
I didn't need to wake up this early. In fact, this is hours and hours before we're gonna go to the airport.
Stop right there! You see, I hadn't actually woken up when this shot was taken. In reality, I'd woken up hours before because I had a cold and needed to make a Lemsip. That's just some behind the scenes movie magic for you.
Or I could have just abandoned it. I probably should have just abandoned it.
I don't know, maybe I'll narrate the thing and I won't really call it a vlog, I'll call it a recap, something like that. I don't know.
This version of the video exists as a healthy middle ground to essentially scratch an itch in a part of my brain that demanded closure for a fucking holiday movie. But also I felt it necessary to add this bit in at the end so that the struggle was documented in some way. Oh, it's just, it's so many levels of wank. So to reiterate, there is no poignant conclusion to this narrative, it just ends. But I would like to ask a question to the one and only intended audience member of this collection of memories edited into a flashy montage. Ezra, are you satisfied with the outcome? You stupid fucking dumb fuck.
This video better pick up from this point on. It's gonna be exciting. It's gonna be mind blowing. There's gonna be twists and turns. There'll be fights, but in the end, it will be a beautiful story. And if it's not, then... whoops!